Good morning, students. Myself Aman Thakur. In today's lecture, we will study about the laws of chemical combinations. So, there are the following laws. That is, first is law of conservation of mass. Second is law of constant proportions. Third one is law of multiple proportions. And the last one is law of reciprocal proportions. In this video, we will study one by one about these laws. So first of all, there is law of conservation of mass. What is law of conservation of mass? In all physical changes and chemical reactions, the total mass of the products is the same as the total mass of the reactants. For instance, we will take the example. You can see here, there is the 30 kg of flock along with the 1 kg of fire as a reactants. But as a product, we will get the same as the number of reactants, like there is 28 kg of ash along with the 3 kg of smoke. Next is law of constant composition. What is law of constant composition? According to this law, a pure chemical compound always consists of the same elements combined together in a fixed proportion by weight. For example, we will take the examples of water molecule and a piece of cake. In case of water molecule, the chemical formula for the compound water is always H2O. Water is always 11% of hydrogen by mass and 89% of oxygen by mass. It doesn't matter whether the water is found in nature or synthesized in the lab. It always has the same composition. Next is the law of constant compositions, second example. That is a piece of cake. What would happen if I take a small bite of cake or a giant bite of cake? Would it taste same? Of course. The composition of the cake is the same all the way through. A compound like sugar or salt is the same no matter where you find it or how much you have. Next is the law of multiple proportions. What is the law of multiple proportions? According to the law of multiple proportions, if two elements combine to form two or more compounds, the weight of one of the elements which combine with a fixed weight of the other in these compounds bear a simple whole number ratio by weight. For example, compounds of nitrogen and oxygen. This is example of law of multiple proportion. Here you can see that there is the oxides of nitrogen, like there is a nitrous oxide, there is a nitric oxide, there is a nitric trioxide, there is also a nitrogen pentoxide. So what will happen? The ratio between the weights of oxygen, all the above listed oxides, which combine with 14 parts by weight of the nitrogen is 18:16:24:32:40. Next is the law of reciprocal proportions. According to the definition, the ratio by which two elements combine separately with a fixed weight of the third element is either the same or is a simple whole number multiple of the ratio in which these elements combine with each other. For example, we take the example of H2S, SO2 and H2O. In first example, there is H2S. The molecular weight of single hydrogen is 1, whereas the molecular weight of sulfur is 32. So the ratio between this is 1:16. So as same in the another example, you can see there is SO2, so molecular weight is 32 and oxygen has, single oxygen has molecular weight 16, and there is the two molecules of hydrogen, oxygen, so the molecular weight becomes 32. So the ratio is 1:1, and same as in the other examples. In the last, we will get the ratio, is 1:2. This is the example of law of reciprocal proportions. Thank you.